speaker is a grade 9 student at Stratford Central Secondary School. He was the first Avon Maitland District School Board student to be elected to serve on the Minister of Education Student Advisory Committee. He's an active student leader and was peer nominated as his grade 8 valedictorian. Please welcome Matt Knarr with Leap of Faith, Making the Jump into High School.
Hi guys, so as she said, my name is Matt Knarr. I'm a grade 9 student over at Stratford Central, and today I'm going to be talking about helping students make the transition over to high school. So I was originally approached by Steve Howe, who is our technical director today, to make a presentation about being a niner. But our lives aren't very different from yours. We eat, we sleep, we poop, et cetera, et cetera. The only major difference is just transitioning into high school. So through this presentation, I'm going to cover what we're doing well, what strategies are working, what we're doing wrong, and how can we fix it, both looking system-wide and specifically at individuals, how one person can make a difference. So the major thing that we're doing right, we know what's coming. Before we even get into high school, we know the homework levels are going to be up, the responsibilities of picking courses and getting to class on time is going to be up, and together this makes things so much easier just because so much fear of high school is based on the unknown. Never been through something like this, so we're afraid. We know where the help is. Guidance is posted everywhere. The teachers come in and talk to us at the beginning of the year. And in grade 8, the idea of talking to your teachers is really stressed because communication is such a big part in high school where the curriculum moves so fast. We're given theoretical skills and resources to help us both with the transition and through the rest of high school. So this can range from things like online post-secondary planning to just homework skills, like not procrastinating. Right, Mom? She's giving me a wink and a nudge. That's something I'm bad at. So together, this has made a really successful transition. We can see almost all students are at least somewhat satisfied with their transition, and most are at least satisfied. So what are some things that aren't working? There's a very clear break in the mentalities between middle school and high school. Suddenly, it's from your teachers taking over your education to you really grabbing hold of the reins and taking responsibility for your learning. A lot of fear is put into it. I was once told, oh, you're going into grade 9? Oh, I'm sorry. So maybe just taking that back a bit. And the current methods of teaching transition don't work for everyone. Just like with any curriculum, there are always going to be some learners who are disadvantaged by the way it's taught. So in this case, kinesthetic learners. So how could we fix all these problems? Well, the main thing is just easing into it. Instead of just saying over the summer, okay, you are now responsible for your education, have fun. Slowly increasing the course load in 7 and 8, increasing the responsibilities, et cetera, et cetera. Also, stemming from that point, adding more responsibility while we're in grade 7 and 8. So breaks with no bells, stuff like that. And not just that, adding consequences for the actions in that. Right now we have some responsibility in 7 and 8, but if you don't do it, oh, that's fine. We can take care of it for now. And finally, market it differently. Instead of this big leap, just a change in mindset. That'll make the first day easier for everyone. Give it a minute to catch up. I'm bad at advanced presentations. So all of these were kind of system-wide things that one person can't just go in and change everything. Getting out there is really key. I had the opportunity to visit a grade 10 math class before I went into high school, and just sitting there and getting the idea of how fast things move, how the homework moves, just made everything so much easier. So what can we as parents, teachers, and peers do? I think there are some peers out there somewhere. Instead of just having a whole system-wide thing, taking it into our individual hands. So don't push anything. Tying back to the stress presentation, if you bottle everything down and say, okay, this is going to be hard, you're going to have to push through it, don't. Just let people adapt. That's what we do. Also, when you want to get involved into the process, ask some alumni what they did, ask the schools what's happening, and if you want to, volunteer at some events. And...